charges him for a very short amount of time to realise he is never on time. He's always late. I'm quite surprised he turned up today. But you can guarantee whenever you meet Andrew, or arrange to meet Andrew, in a pub, you guarantee he'll only second fight place. And also, when he leaves the pub, you can guarantee you're waiting outside for him because he's met someone between where you're standing and the door. Chatting to him.
Yes.
So Andrew is a very sociable person. Everywhere he goes, he meets someone he knows and starts chatting. A little story not so long ago. Andrew's next door neighbour was found collapsed on the floor in a bad way. It was Andrew's job to call the ambulance. Lo and behold, the paramedic who turned up was an old school friend of Andrew. And we'd seen each other for a long time. Launched into a full-on chat about the old days. In the meantime, the neighbour was still stretched out on the floor, twitching away. Luckily, he made full recovery. Another thing, many of you might not know about Andrew, he is the neatest man I've ever met. He's a neat and tidy man. He even folds his socks. And his CDs are in alphabetical order.
I've never had a kid yet.
move on to being Newport's very own Rick Astley.
Thank you, man.
Smart blazers, nice tie, all that sort of stuff. But Andrew, he was the man about town in the 80s and 90s. He could often be seen in all the trendy bars in Newport. But his favourite was Lloyd's. So Andrew made such an impression on the staff and the regulars that when he stopped going there, he'd shut it down and turn it into a fast food. That they planted on the wall next to the disabled toilet to commemorate his exploits. Make your own jokes up at that point, there is a joke in the world. These days, he has toned his fashion sense down quite a bit. Andrew loves to wear brown. If he fancies a change, maybe blue.